it's Alicia here, and I wanted to film a video about if you have acid reflux, why that might be and what a potential cause could be that's keeping that in place for you. And I recently figured out what that is for me, and that's why I wanted to share this, because I've had acid reflux for a really long time. It feels like something's like burning my insides, to be honest, is what it feels like. And through working with my mentor, Dr. Kim DeRamo, who's super intuitive and is able to scan your energy field and know exactly what it is that is keeping you stuck, was able to tell me what has been keeping this stomach issue in place. And that for me, and likely for you if you also have acid reflux, is that you're swallowing or suppressing something that you're feeling. And it could even be that you suppress it so much that sometimes it does come out and it feels like you're choking because you just want to say it and it's like eating at you, and maybe it does eventually come out what you're truly feeling, but it doesn't come out in a loving way because it was like literally eating at you and you were swallowing it and like choking on it and suppressing it. And I do have a separate video about the main cause of most illnesses and diseases, which is suppression. And I will put a link to that here if you want to watch that, but it always is some sort of suppression. Are you suppressing your feelings, suppressing your authentic self, or do you not want to feel what you're feeling? That's what usually leads to any sort of discomfort or dis-ease or illness. And so if you have acid reflux, it could literally be that you are swallowing your feelings and not expressing them or not even being willing to feel them yourself. And it can come up, especially if you have acid reflux that really does come all the way up your esophagus. It could be that you literally feel like you're choking because you're not sharing what you want to share. And I've heard people say that. And for me, it's really low in my stomach, literally feels like it's burning my insides. And that's exactly what the physical symptom feels like. And that's also exactly what the emotion feels like when I'm not expressing what I'm feeling. It literally feels like it's eating my insides, like it's eating at me. And so it really makes sense that this is the reason why. And I have been noticing relief from it the more that I express what I'm truly feeling with those that I've always suppressed what I was feeling with. I've never shared with certain people how I was truly feeling, and then once I started to, I started to see relief in my acid reflux. So I would recommend you try that. But I do want to be clear that that does not mean, especially because if you have been suppressing it, it can come out in a very not loving way and can be very hurtful to everyone around you. So what I'd recommend is constantly throughout the day, every day, tuning into your body, tuning into what you're feeling, asking yourself, what do you need right now? And if there is something that wants to be shared and expressed that's like eating at you, tune in a little further. Like, how does this need to be expressed? Is just journaling about it enough? Is just being willing to sit with the emotions enough? Or is there something you really want to share with somebody? And then tune in even further to think, how does this person really need to hear this that will be received in the best way possible, that is expressed in a loving way, that isn't hurtful, that isn't pointing fingers at somebody? Because it's very important to remember that everything and everyone in your life is a reflection of you. There is nobody to blame. If somebody is triggering you, it's because of energy that you're holding on to. So there's no reason to point fingers or blame anybody for what's coming up for you. I really do think sitting with your emotions and tuning in daily and showing your body that it's not being ignored could be enough, or maybe it does need to be expressed through journaling or to an actual person, and that's what you're going to have to tune in and feel out for yourself. Slowly, daily, every day, so it doesn't come out in that way that you feel like you're choking or that it's like eating at you. And, you know, that's really similar for when you can't sleep as well. People who can't sleep, it's usually some sort of powerlessness. It could be subconscious that your body doesn't know that it's powerful enough to sit with those emotions that you were unwilling to feel or meet throughout the day, every day. So if you're constantly living in suppression to your emotions and you're always trying to keep busy so that you don't have to feel them, and then you go to sleep at night and you can't sleep, it's because your body doesn't know that it can move through that. It can slow down and it will be okay if all the emotions come to the surface. You have the power to move through them with ease. So what I'd recommend for that, which is very similar to the acid reflux, is throughout the day, every day, tuning into your body more, being willing to feel what you're feeling and what's coming up for you, so that when you do go to sleep, it's not this drastic change from being super busy and distracted to, okay, now it's time to settle down and now all the emotions are going to come to the surface and am I going to be able to feel this and handle this and sit through this. You might not be aware consciously that that's what's happening, but subconsciously it's probably some sort of powerlessness that your body doesn't know that it is powerful enough to sit through those emotions and that it will be okay. And it will know that if you start to tune in and presence your emotions throughout the day, so it's not this drastic change by the time you go to sleep at night. So same thing with the acid reflux. Tune into your body daily. What are you feeling? Is there something that wants to be expressed? How can you express it in a loving way that isn't suppressing and eating at you and feels like you're choking because you're not sharing it? So I hope that this is helpful for you and you do see relief if you have acid reflux. And if you did like this video, please give it a thumbs up, hit subscribe, and hit the bell button if you want to be notified the next time I upload a video. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.